So today's topic is electrochemistry. So what is electrochemistry? Electrochemistry deals with interconversion between chemical and electrical energy. Chemical energy is converted to electrical energy and vice versa. Now, electrochemistry involves redox reaction. Redox reaction means oxidation reduction reactions. Redox reduction. Oxidation reduction reactions. So these redox reaction actually it involves electron transfer during oxidation. Actually electron releases and during reduction electron is accepted. So what is electrochemical reaction? In electrochemical reactions, electrons are transferred from one species to another. Now we have to discuss, so how we can assign this oxidation and reduction through oxidation number. So we can assign oxidation and reduction through changing oxidation number. So for this reaction like that, this is the hydrogen formation reaction, hydrogen gas formation reaction. When zinc is dissolved in the sulfuric acid, zinc sulfate is formed and hydrogen is released. Zinc plus H plus to form zinc plus hydrogen gas. Zinc in elemental state, the oxidation number is 0. H plus means oxidation number of hydrogen is plus 1. Zinc 2 plus, here the oxidation number of zinc is plus 2. And hydrogen in gas state, H2 state, oxidation number is 0. So in order to keep the track of what loses electrons and what gains electrons, we assign oxidation number. So in a chemical reaction, which species loses electrons and which actually accepts electrons, we actually use for tracking this electron transfer, we are using oxidation number. Now for this particular reaction, when zinc solid means zinc major reacts with H plus to form zinc plus, zinc 2 plus and hydrogen gas, the oxidation number of zinc is 0 to plus 2. So change of oxidation number is 0 to plus 2. So this is oxidation and hydrogen plus 1 to 0, that means lowering of oxidation number, it is called reduction. So for this particular reaction, 0, 2 plus 2. It is oxidation. And plus 1 to 0 is reduction. So what is reduced is the oxidizing agent. So which reduces itself? Here H plus oxidizes zinc by taking electrons from it. So H plus is the reducing agent. And what is oxidized is reducing agent. So zinc reduces H plus to hydrogen gas. So zinc is the reducing agent. Like hydrogen in gaseous form, zinc in metallic form, the oxidation number is 0. The oxidation number of monoatomic ion is the same as it is charged. Like zinc 2 plus, the oxidation number is plus 2 because it is a monoatomic ion. In H plus, oxidation number is plus 1 because it is monoatomic ion. No metals tend to have negative oxidation number, although some are positive in certain compounds. So metals are always tend to have positive oxidation number and non-metals. So oxygen has an oxidation number of minus 2, except in peroxide, which has an oxidation number of minus 1. So non-metals tend to have negative oxidation number, although some are positive in certain cases. Oxygen is always in minus 2 form, but in hydrogen peroxide it is minus 1 form. Hydrogen is minus 1 when it is bonded with metal like sodium hydride. In sodium hydride, hydrogen is minus 1 and sodium is plus 1. But in water hydrogen is plus 1 and oxygen is minus 2. So hydrogen is minus 1 when bonded to metal and plus 1 when bonded to non-metal. Fluorine is the most electronegative element. Fluorine always has an oxidation number of minus 1. The other halogens have an oxidation number of minus 1. When they are negative, they can have positive oxidation number. However, most notably in oxyanions. The sum of the oxidation number in a neutral compound is 0. The sum of the oxidation number in a polyatomic ion is a charge on the ion. Now, how we can balance a particular redox reaction? So first we have to assign the oxidation number and we have to write separate half reaction for oxidation and reduction. For this particular reaction, we have to write one reaction zinc, one half reaction. The half reactions are zinc to zinc 2 plus plus 2e, and another half reaction is, this is oxidation half reaction. Now reduction half reaction is H plus 2H plus plus 2E, 2H2 gas. So this is reduction of reaction. So for each half reaction, we have to balance the elements involved in the electron transfer. Balance the number of electrons lost and gained. To balance electrons, multiply each half reaction by whole numbers. Add half reaction and cancel the like terms. Balance for acidic condition, balance oxygen using water and hydrogen using acid H+. For basic condition, balance oxygen with hydroxide ion and hydrogen with water. Check that all atoms and charges balance. So balancing is most important for determining the oxidation reduction reaction. For redox reaction, balancing is very important. We can do it by half reaction method. Now, the redox reaction can be categorized in two ways. One is direct redox reaction, another is indirect redox reaction. Direct redox reaction is oxidizing and reducing agents are mixed together, and indirect redox reaction is oxidizing and reducing agents are separated but connected electrically. Example, when zinc and copper can be reacted indirectly as well as directly. When zinc rod is dipped in copper sulfate solution, what happens? Zinc 2+ is formed and copper is deposited. When zinc 2, 0, 2+2, oxidation. Copper 2+2 copper is reduction. So this can be done in direct redox way or indirect redox way, and these redox reactions are basis of electrochemistry. So this is a zinc rod and this is the copper sulfate solution. So when zinc rod is dipped in copper sulfate solution, we found that there is a layer of deposition of copper metal forms. Because this is the reaction. So voltaic cell, in case of electrochemical cell, can be categorized in two ways. One is voltaic cell, another is electrochemical cell. So cell electrochemical cell can be categorized mainly two ways. One is voltaic cell, another is electrolytic cell. Electrolytic cell. So in case of voltaic cell, the spontaneous reaction generates electrical energy, and in electrolytic cell absorbs free energy from an electrical source to drive a non-spontaneous reaction. So we can employ this reaction, this is a spontaneous reaction, we can employ this reaction in voltaic cell or galvanic cell. So in cell, the common components are electrodes which conduct electricity between cell and surroundings. Another is electrolyte, the mixture of ions involved in the reaction or carrying charge. Another component is there, it is the salt bridge. It provides charge balance or completes the circuit. Now, voltaic cell is a device in which chemical energy is changed to electrical energy. It uses spontaneous reaction. So this is the picture of a spontaneous reaction when zinc rod is placed in copper sulfate solution. So zinc solution. setup is called voltaic cell. So a typical cell looks like this. This is the typical picture of voltaic cell. A typical cell looks like this. The oxidation occur at anode. Here zinc is used as anode and copper is used as cathode because oxidation occur at anode. And the movement of electron is in this way from cathode to anode. And movement of cation is from anode to cathode. Now this is a reducing agent. Zinc is a reducing agent. It self-oxidizes and copper is the oxidizing agent. So zinc, actually this is the electrolytic solution here. Use zinc sulfate or copper sulfate. So once even one electron flows from anode to cathode. If one electron flows from anode to cathode, the charge balance is lost. Anode to cathode, the charge in each beaker would not be balanced and the flow of electron will stop. For that reason, we are using a charge balancer that is called salt bridge. For that reason, therefore we use a salt bridge, usually U-shaped tube. This is the salt bridge filled with sodium nitrate. That contains a salt solution to keep the charge balanced. The cation moves towards cathode and anode. Cathode is a negative electrode. For that reason, cation moves towards cathode and anion moves towards anode. So zinc 2 plus 2e and copper 2 plus 2e 2 copper solid. This is the reaction. So salt bridge allows the ion migration such that the solution will remain neutral. If the salt bridge is not there, the ion balance, the ionic balance actually lost. So in a voltaic cell, the electrons leave the anode and flow through the wire to the cathode. As the electrons leave the anode, the cations form dissolve into the solution in the anode. So as the electrons reach the cathode, cations in the cathode are attracted to the now negative cathode and electrons are taken to the cation and the neutral metal is deposited or cathode. So this is the picture of a voltaic cell, zinc copper voltaic cell. It is the anode, it is the cathode, and cathode is gradually increases. The volume of cathode gradually increases because copper is deposited on cathode, but zinc is actually converted to zinc 2 plus, so volume of anode gradually decreases. So the anode is destroyed and cathode is increased. Now in electromotive force, the potential difference between anode and cathode in the cell is called EMF, electromotive force, or cell potential, or E cell. So the difference between cathode and anode is called E cell. E cell is equal to so E cell can be measured by volt. 1 volt is equal to 1 joule means watt or electrical potential energy by unit charge move. So joule per coulomb is called volt. So standard cell potential, E0 cell means the cell potential under standard condition. Elements in standard state. Elements are at 298 Kelvin temperature. 1 molar solution is there and the pressure is 1 atmosphere. So this is the standard electrode potential for various for that electrode system. So here, like a zinc electrode is attached with hydrogen, standard hydrogen electrode. The standard hydrogen electrode, the potential is 0 and zinc is, it is 0.764. So the cell potential and standard potential can be defined as E0 cell is equal to the reduction potential of cathode minus reduction potential of anode. Because cell potential is best for the potential energy per unit of charge. It is an intensive properties, independent of the mass of the system. So for zinc electrode system, zinc copper, this is a zinc copper holding cell. Zinc reduction potential for zinc, 2 plus 2 zinc is 0.76 volt, where the reduction potential for copper, 2 plus 2 copper is 0.34 volt, it is minus 764. So for that reason, E0 reduction potential of cathode minus reduction potential of anode is equal to E0 cell. So it is 1.104. So it is the EMF for this system. So the from the table of standard reduction potential, the strongest oxidizer have most positive reduction potential value, and the strongest reducers have most negative reduction potential value. So lithium is the strongest reducing agent, and from this table found that fluorine is the strongest oxidizing agent and hydrogen is 0 volt. So the greater the difference between the oxidizing and reducing agent, the greater is the voltage cell potential for the particular cell. In zinc copper cell, zinc is minus 7.6 and copper is plus 3.4. So the potential difference is E0 cell is 1.10 volt. Now we will start electrochemical thermodynamics.
Mu is equal to mu plus Z
F and 5. Z, F, 5. F is Faraday. Z is the charge on the particle. F is Faraday's constant.
Get extracted electrically from a system.
So when you put the value W is equal to V into Q, where V is the volt, electric potential, and Q is the charge. Q is equal to NF. So W electrical is equal to NFE. So by convention, we identify what which is negative with what which is being done by the system and the surroundings, and negative free energy change is identified as defining the spontaneous process. So for when the work is done by the system and the surroundings, we can say delta GPT is equal to minus NFE. In this way, the measurement of cell potential directly calculates the Gibbs free energy change for the process. So, how does chemical nature change with activity? Integration of the expression for dependence of amount of material and Gibbs function leads to the following relation: mu is equal to mu zero plus RT ln. A is a, once we have the chemical potential at the reference state, that is mu zero, we can readily calculate the changes of activity changes, usually as a result of changes in amount of material resulting from the chemical reaction. This will be the foundation by which we analyze any given chemical process to determine its equilibrium position. So for a particular chemical reaction, WAA plus XBB, YC plus ZD, in order to analyze the chemical process mathematically, we form this reaction quotient. This is the activity of the product minus activity of the reactant. It tells us products in the numerator and reactants in the denominator. It explicitly records the activity of each reaction participants, and each term is raised to the power of its stoichiometric coefficient. So how does Gibbs free energy change with activity, or concentration for dilute solution? Activity can be converted to concentration replaced by concentration term. Some dependence as with chemical potential, where G is equal to same dependence as with the chemical potential, G is equal to G0 plus RT ln A. When we apply this to reaction, the reaction quotient come into play, give us G is equal to G0 delta G plus equal to delta G0 plus RT ln Q. Q contains all the activity of terms of the reactants and products, each raised to its stoichiometric coefficient. So delta G is equal to delta G0 plus RT ln Q. When activity A is equal to 1 and Q is equal to 1, ln Q is equal to 0. So delta G is equal to delta G0. Reaction proceeds and Q changes until finally at equilibrium delta G0 is equal to 0. Then we get delta G0 is equal to minus RT ln Q star, and this Q star is for equilibrium constant, K equilibrium. Use the definition of delta G, we found that when Q is equal to 1, we have delta G is equal to delta G0. This is the way we design the equation. What is more interesting is to see what happens when delta G goes to 0. Here is when it reached equilibrium, the various concentrations in the reaction stop changing. The reaction seems to stop. In this case, we obtain the relation between delta G0 and the equilibrium constant. The reaction doesn't really stop. We simply have reached the situation where the forward and reverse reaction rates are equal. Chemical activity is still ongoing with just as much vigor as before, but it is happening equally in both directions. Products are reacting to turn into reactants, just as fast as reactants are reacting to turn into products. This is why we call it a dynamic equilibrium rather than a static equilibrium. Now delta G is equal to minus NFE. So where F is 96500 coulomb per mole, is equal to minus NaFe0. This means minus NaFe is equal to minus NaFe0 plus RTLnQ is called Nernst equation. And putting this value, we get that E is equal to, by dividing by NF, we get dividing both sides by NF, we get the Nernst equation. E is equal to E0 minus RT by NF ln Q. Using log base 10 logarithms, E is equal to E0 minus 2.303 RT by NF log Q. So this is up to, this is the electrochemical thermodynamics. So 2.303 RT by NF is equal to 0.592. For that reason, we can write E is equal to E0 minus 0.0592 by N log Q.